Hey, what's up, guys? It's Carlos or Acidglow here. So let's talk about the stage finishers, the danger moves, and the ultimate combos in Killer Instinct 1 and 2, and if we'll possibly see them in Killer Instinct 3. So let's start off with the very first Killer Instinct game. So we had the standard ultra combos, which everyone knows about. We also have the stage finishers, which basically allowed you to knock someone off the rooftop of a level and then they'd fall down and like go splat on the ground. Now, we also had the danger moves, which allowed you to do a finishing move after you depleted the two life bars of the enemy, and providing you did a combo that did not finish them entirely, like an ultra, another ultimate, or a stage finisher. So as long as it was a standard combo that would make them get back up, then you can do a finishing move during their dizzy animation. However, the opponent also had the option to mash the joystick and the buttons repeatedly so they can get out of the dizzy state. And if they did, they'd have like one chip of health and they'd have like a boost of massive damage. Now, we also had the ultimate combos. So the ultimate combos were basically a finishing move during a combo. And of course, you can only do these when the opponent's life bar was flashing red and it said danger. And of course, we also had the humiliations, which I really wasn't too fond of. But this topic is about stage finishers and ultimate combos. Now, in Killer Instinct 2, the format for doing an ultimate combo still remained the same. You can do an opener, an auto, or a manual, then go straight into a finishing move. However, they changed the danger moves up a little bit now. So now in Killer Instinct 2, you no longer had to deplete the two life bars of the enemy and then wait for them to go into a dizzy animation. That was taken out. Now, in order to do the danger zone or the finishing moves, you had to get the opponent's life bar down to flashing red, so it'd say danger. But then they changed it up by having unlimited finishing moves that did chip damage, and you could do them from full screen. They were different, and as much as I like Killer Instinct 2, I was not too fond of this feature. I felt like having unlimited finishing moves that did chip damage from full screen was a little bit too much. However, you could use shadow moves to go right through them. But anyways, so the danger moves were changed a little bit, but the ultimate combos still remained the same. And the stage finishers were pretty much the same, except for, I believe, on Tusk stage, where you had to do a ender that actually popped the opponent up into the air, but it was very stationary, so you had to have the opponent like in the center of the screen, or I believe a portion of the center of the screen, so he'd actually fly up and go into the fiery pit. Although the animation for the stage finishers in Killer Instinct 2 weren't too great. Like, all you would see were the character actually do like these spins and falling down, and then the screen go like flashing red and go, ugh, and then that was it. I think the ones in Killer Instinct 1 kind of were a little bit better, even though they still were kind of cheesy. So the thing with ultimate combos and stage finishers and danger moves, I know the fans really want to see these things come back. And, you know, to be honest, I don't think it would be too hard to actually implement them, because when you look at the finishing moves or ultimate combos, they never really relied on cutting off any limbs or blowing off body parts. So unlike other games like Mortal Kombat, where you'd see like three skulls, you know, 30 ribs, you know, eight toes, you know, like five leg bones, all this stuff. Unlike those finishing moves, the ones in Killer Instinct were pretty simple. They were like Jago's dropping car on the opponent, so he would just like fall down. That was it. His sword slash, like he would slash you twice and then poke you once in the stomach or something. It was like really simple stuff. But the thing is with these ones, I think they might not do them in terms of a danger zone, like, you know, because in Killer Instinct 3, you cannot deplete the two life bars and then have the opponent get back up. After the second life bar is gone, they're down. They're not getting back up. So if we do see danger moves come out in the future, I believe they'd be implemented as ultimate combos. I think that's one way they could still do them. And when you think about the ones in Killer Instinct 2, they kind of remained the same. They were never really too graphic. Like, for example, Tusk, he had like, I think, 30 little meteors come down and then a big one would come down and smash on the opponent. And pretty much the animation for that is the opponent getting hit by multiple attacks and then their body would fall down. So if they do decide to implement stage finishers in Killer Instinct 3, out of the six characters we have available right now, I think Orchid's stage is the only one that could classify as a stage finisher, seeing as how she is inside a building and the other stages are pretty much ground-based, you know? But who knows? Maybe Spinal or Fulgur might have like a rooftop area. We don't know yet. So, anyways, what do you guys want to see more in Killer Instinct 3 in terms of these two previous features? If they could only implement one, which one would you prefer? Do you want to see ultimate combos or do you want to see stage finishers? Let me know in the comments section, guys. Thanks for watching. Please leave a thumbs up. This is Acid Glow, and I will see you guys later on. I'm out.